Rachel had found this front-loading Bosch washer really cheap, and once we put it in place, I wanted to plug it in, and then I noticed it's got one of these plugs on here. 240-volt plug, same as on my table saw. But we never use a dryer, and we do have a 240-volt dryer plug here. So I took an old dryer cord and crudely attached these wires on here just by wrapping electrical tape around them, and we've been using that for a few weeks. So I thought I'd make a more permanent solution, and I bought this 240-volt socket that fits on the cord like so, and I figured I should put that on the end of this cord here to make a more permanent solution. And I just realized a mistake. I forgot to put this part on. Always sucks when you forget to put the hood on the connector. So there's a few wires that got bent back because the wire is really thicker than is meant for that type of connector. So rather than trying to jam those in there, I'm just cutting off the ones that got bent back. And the red and the black are the hot ones, and that goes into the two slots. And this is the ground, and the cord also has a neutral, which this plug doesn't have, so I'm not using that. And the ground hole is a little bit smaller, so I'm having the hardest time getting those wires in. And now the ones that didn't fit, I'll just cut those off. Now there is the neutral one, which I'm just leaving cut off like that. That's okay because this is actually just ground. If you look in the breaker box, this and ground will be hooked up in parallel. So now, which way does this hood go on? They usually only have one way to go on, and that would be this way. This is the same kind of plug as I've got coming off of my table saw. So you could use a cord like that to run a 3-horsepower table saw off your dryer plug. You'll have to take my word for it because I'm not going to drag this table saw over to the house. Now I should add that this type of socket typically has a 15 or 20 amp breaker on it, whereas a dryer typically is about 40 amperes. The wiring in your house will be able to handle the 40 amperes, but maybe if things are overloaded, you might melt the power cord going to your table saw.